prayer. Amen. On Friday, we had a wonderful, wonderful time in the Lord. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. And so, amen, we are finding ourselves back here in the house of the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
It's like home.
No. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
No place like home.
No place like home.
Did anybody have a good time Friday?
Yes, hallelujah. I'm still feasting. Yes, she did. Hallelujah. Yes.
I'm so glad.
Still feasting.
Supporting your part of what the Lord is doing.
Yes.
It's good to be home in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
To be able to worship here.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Be set aside for the name of the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
In the name of Jesus Christ. I want to call your attention to the word of the Lord in the book of Esther.
Oh, glory.
The book of Esther, the
Thank you,
chapter.
Jesus.
And I'm going to read it out of the King James Version first, and then I'm going to read it out of the King James Version. I'm going to read it out of the New Living Translation. Is that all right?
That's all right, Pastor.
So I'll read it out of the King James first, and then the New Living Translation. It's Esther, fourth chapter. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. And we will begin at verse number 6.
Uh-huh.
Amen. And at verse number 6. Amen. We'll read all the way down. Amen. By the help of the Lord, we'll read down to verse number 14.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. So Esther, the fourth chapter, verse number 6, all the way down to verse number 14.
Yes, Lord.
And it says, Hatach went forth to Mordecai unto the street of the city, which was before the king's gate.
Uh-huh.
And Mordecai told him of all that had happened unto him, and of the sum of the money that Haman had promised to pay the king's treasuries for the Jews to destroy them. Also he gave him the copy of the writing of the decree that was given at Shushan. To destroy them, to show it unto Esther, and to declare it unto her, and to charge her that she should go in unto the king to make supplication. Somebody say, make supplication.
Make supplication.
Unto him.
Yes.
And to make requests before him for her people. And Hatach came and told Esther the words of Mordecai. And again, Esther spake unto Hatach and gave him commandment unto Mordecai. All the king's servants and the people of the king's province do know that whosoever, whether man or woman, shall come unto the king into the inner court who is not called, there is one law of his to put him to death, except such to whom the king shall hold out the golden scepter that he may live.
Yes.
But I have not been called to come in unto the king these 30 days. And he told to Mordecai Esther's words. Then Mordecai commanded to answer Esther, think not with thyself that thou shalt escape in the king's house more than all the Jews.
Oh, Lord.
For if thou altogether holdest thy peace at this time, then shall their enlargement and deliverance arise to the Jews from another place. But thou and thy father's house shall be destroyed. And who knoweth whether thou art come to the kingdom for such a time as this?
Yes.
We'll read chapter number 4, amen, at verse number 6, from the New Living Translation. And it says, Hatach went out to the city square and found Mordecai just outside the palace gate and heard the whole story from him. And about the $20 million that Haman had promised to pay
Jesus
into the king's treasury for the destruction of the Jews. Mm. And somebody might say, well, King James didn't give us how much. But if you go to Esther, the third chapter, the ninth verse, it tells you how much silver he promised.
Yes, yes.
And their equivalent of their silver came out to $20
million. My Lord.
And he promised to pay it for the destruction of the Jews. And Mordecai also gave Hatach a copy of the king's decree dooming all the Jews. And told him to show it to Esther to tell her what was happening. And that she should go to the king to plead for her people. And Hatach returned to Esther the words of Mordecai. Esther told Hatach to go back and say to Mordecai, all the world knows that anyone, whether man or woman, who goes into the king's inner court without his summons is doomed to die, unless the king hold out his gold scepter. And the king has not called for me to come to him in more than a month. So Hattach gave Esther's message to Mordecai. Then Mordecai replied to Esther, "Do you think you will escape there in the palace when all other Jews are killed? If you keep quiet,
Jesus,
at a time like this,
my Lord,
God will deliver the Jews from some other source.
Jesus.
But you and your relatives will die. What's more, who can say what God has brought you into the palace for just a time as this?"
Jesus.
Just for a few moments, I just want y'all to help me to just declare this thought. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
You were saved.
You were saved.
For this.
For this.
Look at your other neighbor. Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
You were saved.
You were saved.
For this.
For this. Hallelujah.
You were saved.
Saved for this.
For this. So we read the story of Esther and we find out the circumstances surrounding what is currently transpiring. We find that there has been given a certain amount of money. A man by the name of Haman. And the total sum of the money is $20 million. He's paying $20 million in order that the people might kill.
Look at that.
And destroy the people of God.
Amen.
The people of God, wherever they go, wherever environment they're in, they always cause a threat to unbelievers.
Amen. Amen.
Church quiet in here.
Amen.
It always calls a threat to unbelievers. No matter where you put sanctified people of
that's
God,
right,
they will always cause a threat to the kingdom of Satan.
That's right.
Because we are people that only believe in one God.
That's right. Amen.
I said we are people that only believe in one God.
One God.
Because we believe in one God, it is hard for us to be moved to worship any God other than the God that we serve.
That's right. Amen.
And so the Jews would always find themselves somehow in captivity. And then when they would get in captivity, they would always be forced to have to bow down to the gods of the people or to bow down to the king as a god. And God's people would say, no, we only serve one God. And because we serve one God,
that's
we
right,
bow to him only.
That's only.
Lord, I pray that we will not turn to the left, neither will we turn to the right.
Right.
We're going to stay flat-footed
that's
upon
right
the word of God.
That's
there's just
right
some things we don't do. There's
amen
just some things we don't say. There's
amen
just some things we don't wear. There's just some ways
amen
we don't act. Because
amen
we are the people of God.
People of God.
And so the Jews will always find themselves getting into trouble because of their stand for the word of God. And it's no different today. We, as the people of God, will always find ourselves outcast and ridiculed.
Yep.
We'll find ourselves being pushed aside when we want to stand
amen
for the word of God.
That's right, every time.
So the Jews found themselves in a terrible predicament. And now the price has been given on their head for $20 million in order that they might kill the people of God. So word gets back to the camp of the Jews that $20 million had been put over their head in order that they might be killed and be destroyed. But there is a woman who is in the king's palace. And she is the queen and her name is Esther.
Esther.
And so Mordecai, who is related to Esther, comes up with a plot and says to Esther, Esther, the enemy of God's people is trying to destroy us. The enemy of God's people
yeah
is trying to kill us. And he's willing to pay a price
yes
of $20 million that he might destroy us. He wants us dead.
Dead.
He wants
right
us destroyed. He wants us defeated. He wants us to be killed.
That's right.
But Esther, God has positioned you and God has placed you in the palace. And Esther, we need you to do something. We need you to go into the king. And we need you to plead and to supplicate before the king for your people. Esther, we need you to beg the king
yes
that the king might deliver laboring for the king, and we want you to beg on behalf of your people. Somebody shout, intercede.
Intercede.
And even though this is a natural occurrence, what Mordecai's telling Esther is that we need you to intercede on behalf of the people.
Yes.
We need you to go in there and pray to the king that he will deliver God's people.
That's right.
Because God's people is going through hardship, and they're going through trouble, and they're about to be destroyed by the enemy of God's people. But Esther, if you pray to the king,
hey, Jesus,
we know that the king will deliver.
Yes.
So Esther sends word back and says, well, you know that there's a rule that can't nobody come to the king unless the king calls them. And if you're not called and you go into the inner court, and the king looks at you and he does not hold out the golden scepter, you are to be put to death.
Amen.
You are to die, and you're to be murdered if you go into the king's presence without his permission. Lord, I praise you. But the king is so glorious that you can't just enter into his presence any kind of way.
That's right, that's right.
You have to be invited into the presence of the king.
Jesus.
Lord, I praise you. And we're talking about a natural kingdom.
Yes.
And a natural kingdom. Now, what about the King of Kings and the Lord?
Yes.
Of the Lord. You can enter into his presence any kind of way.
Oh, glory.
So said that if he don't call you, you can't come. Because it's a privilege to be in the presence
of
the
king. Yes, it is.
Lord, I pray
you. Yes,
it's an honor to be in the presence of the king. Get everybody not grace with the presence of the king.
That's right.
Oh, but when we get grace with the presence of the king, it's a delight to be in his presence. It's a joy to be in his presence. It's an honor to be in the presence of the king.
Thank you, Lord.
So Esther says, it's been 30 days, and I have not been given summons to go into the presence of the king. 30 days. And here I am in the palace, and I can't even see the man. And it's been 30 days, an entire month, and I have not been graced to go into his presence. So Mordecai returns word to her and says, well, I understand that you may not have been called into his presence, but the people of God are in an urgent situation.
Amen.
Y'all got to get with me today. I preach to myself.
Come on, come on.
They're in an urgent situation. The situation, it's life and death.
Uh-huh.
In other words, Esther, you can't be concerned about whether or not you've been summoned into his presence. We need you to go into his
that's
presence.
That's right, that's right.
Lord,
hallelujah.
You can't wait to be asked to come. You got to go into the presence of the Lord, because somebody like depends
that's
upon
right.
you.
Jesus. Jesus.
Somebody like depends upon you going into the presence of
Jesus.
The Lord.
Jesus.
Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
You've been saved.
For this.
Esther, we need for you to go into the presence of the king. So she makes up in her mind and she resolves in her heart that I'm going into the presence of the king. And even though the rule says that you got to die if he does not receive you, I'm willing to die if I have to die.
Jesus.
Esther said, if I perish, then
let
I
me perish.
But I'm going to
see
the
king.
The king.
Yes.
And can I tell you something? Mordecai looked at Esther in his mind and said, how don't you understand and know that God has positioned you in the kingdom for this very moment? Can I let you know something? That God has saved every last one of us.
Uh-huh.
And he's brought us into his heavenly kingdom. And it was not to come in here and look cute.
Y'all
still ain't grasped him yet, but I'm getting ready to go to my seat already. God brought you out of darkness into In order for them to be in his presence.
That's right.
But now we don't need to be summoned. We have full access.
Hey! Thank you, Lord! Thank you, Lord!
Into the presence of the King.
Thank you, Lord!
Lord, every now and again, when we need God to do something, all we got to do is get in his presence.
Yes, yes!
Lord, I praise
yes.
you. Willing to do. So
willing.
The enemy wanted to kill all God's people. But one woman that was willing to lay down her life if she had to.
Jesus.
Made up her mind that I'm willing to lose my life in order that I might save my people.
Jesus.
And can I submit something in y'all today that as it is in the natural, so it is in the spirit. Somebody got a resolve in their mind and leap up in their heart that if I got to die in order to see those around me, I'm willing to die. Die to my will. Die to my flesh. Die to my ways. Die to my understanding.
Help me, Lord.
Esther was willing to die in order that she might save
somebody.
The people of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
She was willing to give up herself in order that somebody else might be delivered.
Thank you, Lord. Oh, Jesus.
So the reality is, we all have been positioned.
That's right.
Into this place.
It's called into
for this moment.
Jesus.
And for this time.
Jesus.
In order that we might deliver people that need to know who God is.
Oh,
people, God. The enemy has put a price tag over their heads. No one said nothing to me.
Jesus.
The price tag that they have on their head is not $20 million. But the Bible said the wages of sin.
Yes. Jesus
makes up her mind.
Thank you, Lord. Thank
to
you.
Lay down her will.
Yes.
To lay down her life. And it's no different when we came this way. Before we were even able to follow Jesus, the Bible said, you got to take up your cross.
That's right.
And follow me.
And follow.
Before you can follow me, you got to crucify something. Y'all quiet in here.
That's right.
Before you can follow me, you got to die.
That's right.
I tell you something, a cross is just not the necklace that some people wear.
Come on.
A cross represents death.
Come
Lord,
on.
I praise you.
But come on.
Because of picking up a cross and you're not about to crucify nothing. In order for you to follow Jesus, you got to take up the cross and you got to nail
hey!
Something to the cross.
That's
you
right.
You got to die to yourself.
Yes,
I praise you. You got to die to your will.
Yes.
You got to die.
Everything outside of God. Hallelujah.
Lord, I bless
you. Oh.
Lord, I praise you.
Hallelujah.
You
oh.
It is only through death and crucifixion that you can deliver the multitudes of people. Lord, I praise you. Some of y'all still want to operate in your flesh. You want to operate in your identity and your personality. But can I tell you something? If you want to draw the masses of people, if you want to see revival in the church of the Lord Jesus Christ, and if you want to see souls baptized in water
hey.
In the name of Jesus
hallelujah.
Christ, and souls filled with the Holy Ghost being
said, if you don't suffer with me, you cannot reign with me. And the reality is, Sister George, there's a whole lot of people that want the glory. Lord, I praise you. And there's a whole lot of people that want the crown. But can I tell you something? Before Jesus was able to go into heaven and sit on the throne and be seated at the right hand of the Father, Lord, I praise you, with a crown upon his head, he had to go through some pain. He had to go through some anguish, and he had to die. And there's no cross, there can be no crown. Lord, I praise you. If there's no suffering, there will be no glory. And we in the church, we sit here and we cry and we pout about what we're going through. But the reality is, if you don't suffer, you can't wait. Lord, I praise you. If you don't go through nothing, you can't be glorified. Lord, I praise you. Some of y'all, every time somebody says something to you, Lord, you're crying and you're pouting. Lord, I praise you. Ready to leave the church and turn your back on God and walk away. Lord, I praise you. Y'all that get with me, I'm going to preach on myself. The sickness is preparation. Lord, I praise you. The disappointment is preparation. Lord, I praise you. The heartache is preparation. Because if you don't suffer, you can't reign well. That's why you should act differently when you're going through your pain, when you're going through heartache, and when you're going through trouble. You ought to lift up your hands and you ought to open up your mouth.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Get to it, Paul.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's shaking us.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Lord, I praise you.
Thank you, Lord.
Don't nobody know the pain and the hell that we've been going through for these past 2 years. That's why I don't understand how some of y'all can sit here when we come into the house of God. We've been going through hardship and trouble, but all of a sudden, while we were enduring and while we remain faithful, here comes God, and he's God giving us favor. Lord, I praise you. On top of favor, and he's God opening doors. Lord, I praise you. To let us know that even though men are against you, that if God be for us, he's more than the world against us. Lord, I praise you. And though 10,000 will rise, Lord, I praise you. God will avenge people. All we have to do is stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Y'all ain't saying nothing here. Lord, I praise you. The pain is our process. So better supply. All that God is doing, are you surprised that he's doing it? No, I ain't surprised, because I can stand it in expectation of what God was going to do. Because it's impossible to suffer the way we've been suffering. It is impossible to go through what you got to go through and God not turn around and bless you. Lord, I praise you. When there's no trouble in the church, I was lifting my hands and said, I bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continue to be in my mouth. The enemy attacked my body and I got sick, but I said, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall be in my mouth. Financial trouble, Lord, I praise you. But I said, I will bless the Lord at all times. And because I was determined to go through with praise, Lord, I praise you. Because I was determined to go through with joy, Lord, I pray. Before I bent and before I caved in and before I gave up, I said, I must have more strength to do what God called me to do. And because of it, God said, I'm going to reward you have. Lord, I praise you. And when I bless you, I bless everything that's connected to you. Did you hear what I said? Because favor flows from the head down. Lord, I praise you. That's why it's no accident that a couple of Sundays ago, when we were in South Carolina, that Sister Paulette gave the testimony of how the doctors tried 19 times to put the disc in. Lord, I praise you. And then the doctor sees on the monitor that out of nowhere, the disc flipped. no accident. You know why? It's because God has showered his house with favor. Lord, I praise you. And he brought us into the kingdom for such a time as. Sister Paulette, that's what God allowed, what he allowed. And we thought that he allowed it, and we get disappointed, and we get frustrated with the pain. But the reality is, God said, I'm going to let the pain come, because in a little while, I'm about to show my power. Lord, I praise you. See, we complain sometimes, but God is working a miracle. Lord, I praise you. God is doing something. That's why he said, count it all joy. You didn't hear what I said. That's why he said, count it all joy. Yeah, you got to suffer. And after you suffer a little while, he that shall come, y'all ain't preaching with me. He that shall come will come. And even though the pain is hurtful, even though we don't want to suffer, we got to realize there's going to be glory after this.
Yes, yes.
If I can just hang on, if I can just hold on, God's making a testimony out of my situation. So, Sister Paulette, you don't got to look at the accident that caused you to be in this condition, but you got to look at the God that confounded the minds of the doctors.
Yes.
Some of y'all thought we didn't know the testimony, but we knew it before y'all knew it. And I was holding the mirror when she told me the testimony. But this is why I paid y'all to listen to me good. This is why I paid to listen to the servant of the Lord. Little did you know I was expecting a miracle. Because prior to her operation and what God did, I called for a prayer line one day. And we prayed for Sister Brianna that the Lord would heal her body. And I made a statement. I said, not only will God heal her, but whoever's in here that got sickness, God will work a miracle.
Yes.
Lord, I praise you. And I said, God is sending his healing virtue throughout this house.
Yep.
And because I prayed for one, she stood in proxy for everybody that needed God to do something. So when I got the testimony of how the doctors tried 19 times, Lord, oh Lord, I can understand one time. I can understand two times. I can understand three, because maybe three times a charm. But when you try 19 times and you're a medical professional and you don't know how to get the disc in, but all of a sudden, I walk faith.